So we got a good bit of stealth going on in this game. More than I expected, I'll be honest, already. It's pretty interesting.
I need to do this slowly and quietly. Can't let them see me.
Alright, we got to another spot. Good. Let's just, like, take out this tree and they won't even notice. They actually didn't notice. I thought the game would punish me hardcore for that. Alright. Those things don't move around much. It's the watchers that I need to scan. You right there. You're my next scan. Where do you go? Okay, are you tagged now? I'll highlight the track. There you go. I did not mean to dodge roll. Thank goodness I didn't get punished for that. Go, 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 go. Get to the grass, get to the grass, get to the grass! Yeah, I'm aware. We have to be careful. So many buttons to remember. Alright, get that one. Highlight his track. I keep pressing circle instead of R3 to turn off the vision thing and it makes me dodge roll. Get this out of here. They gonna hear me going through this water? Also, what's the purpose of me getting to the guy? Like, what is that going to accomplish? What happens when I get there? I need to wait for this thing to turn back around. And I just have to hope these things, which apparently eat grass for some reason, to not look up at me. Go now.
I need to see their paths.
Yes, we can see their paths. Don't worry. We're good. Get in the grass. Alright, sick. This is still the only one in my way, I think. There's one over there, but I don't have to worry about it right now. The color of my hair is literally the exact same color used for these patches of tall grass, I swear. Has to be. I wonder how much noise rolling makes. Probably a decent amount. You think I'm not gonna take these trees? Best believe I am. Give me this ridgewood. I might need that in the future.
There he is.
Hey, stupid, how's it going? Grass. It's because I have a magical earpiece. Don't think too hard on it. I rolled again every time.
How are you doing this?
It's called being a child prodigy. Should try it sometime. I am not going across until this guy continues his path. Just gonna go back around that way, and I think I can go right now. Let's find out. Yep, we're good.
How is this possible?
I am a genius. Also, I have a magical mechanical earpiece of justice. Don't worry.
Wait. Oh, Mother, bless that girl. Bless you both.
Boy!
Save me. I just wanted...
Boy! Seal your lips. They are outcasts, both. And she is motherless. Come now. Back to Mother's heart.
That boy should not have spoken to us. It's against tribal law. We'll go home now. Follow.
I know the way.
Man, normally...
Stay away, no mother.
I can't wait to kill him. What? Flashpoints offer moments of emotional choice. Ah, yes. How Aloy... I said Aloy. Wait, is it Aloy? No, Aloy is the metal. Wait, I've forgotten how to pronounce her name. Choose Fist, and she will confront the challenge directly. Choose Brain... No, wait, it went away! Aim for his head, knock the rock from his hands, drop your rock. We're gonna do the brain.
Oh. Hey. Children, away from there. Back to picking berries.
You're bleeding. Let me have a look. Here, hold still. I'll get it.
Why? Why am I an outcast?
Aloy, this is not the time.
Who was my mother?
Aloy, I've told you before, that's not for us to know. You were just a newborn when the matriarchs brought you to me.
So the matriarchs, they know?
It's not so simple.
But they know.
Aloy, we are outcasts.
So how do I make them tell me?
The matriarchs? There is a way, perhaps.
So tell me.
It would be dangerous.
How?
It would take years of training.
I don't care. How do I do it? Tell me.
The proving. The tribe's rite of passage held every year. Those who pass become braves. But to the one who wins, the matriarchs grant a boon.
A boon?
Yes, whatever the winner wants.
Then I'll do it. Whatever it takes. I'll win the proving.
I see. We'd best get started then. Your training will be hard. And it'll take years.
Start training? Yes. Follow.
I sense a time skip coming along. Oh, even better, a training montage. Isn't it kind of unfair though? I got this fancy dancy chip on the side of my face. Yo, kids suck. It doesn't matter what era you're in. Kids are just awful. Also, apparently you've got a double-edged sword here. Normally, main character doesn't have parents, and it's because they've died in some way, or they never met them. And it's just like, man, this sucks. I don't have parents. This causes me angst of some kind. But it's even worse in this universe, because if you don't have a mother, everyone freaking hates you. Got a pretty cool montage going on, though. I assume this is going to take us straight to her, however old she's supposed to be for the majority of the game. I don't know how old she's supposed to be, though. 16? Maybe? She's going in something called the Proving, so that sounds like a coming-of-age thing, so probably somewhere between 13 and 18, anywhere in that range. Or actually, no, 21 could fit, maybe. I guess time will tell. I don't know how old she is now. Like, how old would this be? 8? 9 years old? Somewhere around there? Looks about like that. Maybe even younger, but can you pull all this stuff off when you're like 6? You'd have to be at least 8 or 9, wouldn't you? Up, mechanical pterodactyl comes by, snatches her out of the air, game over. Alright, well that was the rock of time apparently. You jump to it and then you suddenly age drastically. Like multiplies your age by 3 or something. Although I am glad that they got through the opening section of her being a child pretty quickly, because we're still within the first hour of the game and we're already at the correct age. I do like that. Sometimes games have it go too long with the whole setup, different age stuff. You mean to tell me through all these years that stupid chip hasn't, like, gotten knocked off or broken accidentally or I've misplaced it?
Rost?
I've got to remember your name.
Rost? Rost?
Or rather, how to pronounce it. I'm gonna keep wanting to say Aloy.
Where is he? 2 days before the proving and he goes off without me? He wouldn't do that.
All right, Aloy, let's get... I'm just gonna say your name as much as possible. Also, I skipped level 2 because I'm level 3 now for some reason. Ooh. I like this skill tree already. We have 3 skill points. 3,000 to get to level 4? Dude, these enemies better give us, like, a ton of experience. All of these only cost 1. Yeah. Okay. Additional natural resources when foraging. I can already tell I want that. Speeds up healing from the medicine pouch. That'll come in handy, but I don't think it's super important this early in the game. From the tools menu to lure a single enemy to your position, the target will be closest, most centered in Aloy's view. Light spear attacks have an increased chance to knock off armor and components. R1 for a high damage attack on downed enemies. Ooh. While aiming, toggle with R3 to slow down time. To slow down time? Yes. Oh, I have to hold it. There we go. All right, so we're going to learn that. Concentration. Move faster while wielding a heavy weapon. We'll hold off on that. I want level 1 stuff for now. Silent takedown on small machines and humans or deal high damage to medium enemies. I like the sound of that. Time slows while aiming during a jump or a slide. I love slowing time. I love the concept of slowing time. That was in Far Cry 4, I believe. It wasn't in the main game, but in the side missions you could do. I really enjoyed. Landing from a fall or jump is completely silent and will not alert otherwise unaware enemies. I want the time thing. And then I also want... I think I want the silent strike. We're going to take these 3 for now. All right, cool. Very good. Wait, check the other stuff there. We've got notebook has got data points in it, but we've already listened to all of these at the time we got them. I think I might have missed one. Hopefully I can find a way to get back to them at some point. Did I see this one? I don't remember if I did.
You think I want it this way? It's the best.
Oh no, that's the one that she like repeated herself. Okay, so cool. I'm going to try and get as many of these as I can, but I'm going to tell you right now, there are a lot of them, and it feels like probably a lot of them are missable, so if I end up missing some, I apologize. Is there still... What new stuff? Oh, machine catalog. We've got the Watcher and the Strider. They do give a bit of a description here. I like that. Compact, inquisitive, and agile recon unit that will attempt to swarm a target in numbers. Alright. Then it gives you a list of what it can drop and its components of what makes it up. That's really cool. I like that a lot, actually. And then we got the Strider. Herd machines that will bolt when disturbed, so they must be dealt with silently or quickly. Is not mountable yet? Ooh. I look forward to this day of mounting things. What else we got? We got crafting, ammo. We can craft the Hunter Bow arrow packs. Fire arrows, but we need blaze for that. Whatever that is. Whoops. And inventory. We have a spear now. Very good. And we have the Karja Hunter Bow. Is this still like the little tiny bow I had? I think it is. Special items. Nora Machine Trapper Token, Nora Lookout Outfit Token, Nora Long Shot Bow Token. Oh, that's right. These are, because I pre-ordered with GameStop, I got these 3 things as DLC. So we can turn these into a merchant for our special bonuses. So we're going to get a Trapper thing, whatever that is. We're gonna get a new lookout outfit, which is pretty cool, and then we're gonna get a long shot bow as well, which I really look forward to getting that bow. So as soon as we can get to a merchant, we're gonna mess around with that stuff. But anyways, how much time do I have? I got about 5 more minutes. Your spear can knock off machine armor using R1. Try it out on the training dummies. I will. What is this? Is this a save point? Yeah, it is. So let's try this out. Check the item description on your spear for more information. Can do a jumping attack. That's pretty cool. Alright. R2 is like a mega attack. Yeah, it's like a heavy. So we've got like R1 is light attack, R2 is heavy attack. Okay. And then I can switch the bow with L2, and then it switches R2 to using the bow. That was stupid because I have limited ammo. So don't do what I just did. Alright, cool. I'm liking this. I'm liking this a lot. I don't know what the green bar is supposed to be beneath my health. Am I gonna get magical abilities at some point? That's my mana bar, potentially. Or maybe using my heavy attack uses it. Is it like stamina? It doesn't look like it is. Get wrecked. What a bunch of worthless training dummies. I wonder if there's fall damage. I assume there is.
Keep that for later.
Definitely keep that for later. We need health stuff at all times. I can tell you right now, I need as much as I can get my hands on. I assume we have a limited amount of space to hold stuff as well. What is this? More healing? Yeah. Give me all the healing I can get. May as well keep getting all this ridge wood so we can make more arrows at some point. Alright, well, what can we do with the save points? What does this do? Manual save. Anything other than just saving? I thought it was going to turn to nighttime for a second there. The green bar is back down to, like, really low.
He said we'd go hunting this morning. Why isn't he here? Where's he gone to?
I don't know what the green bar does. But I can only assume it's important. We got a zip line over here.
What's he doing up there? He's just standing there.
Is that
him?
What's
going on with him?
Doesn't look like roast from this distance. I just jump up there. Oh, yeah, there we go. Oh, sick. Oh, no. Wait, is it roast? Yeah, it is.
Aloy, you're here.
Is everything okay? Why the holdup? Good thing I know how to track. Is everything okay, dude?
Did you want to be alone?
No. We must speak. I've been thinking about your training, Aloy. You've learned to hunt, learned to survive. But I fear there's a lesson I failed to teach you. Would you learn it now?
Of course. I'll always learn what you have to teach.
There's been some trouble recently. It affords an opportunity to learn this lesson, but it will be dangerous. You must come prepared, or you will die. Descend into the embrace and hunt until you have gathered the parts for fire arrows.
Fire arrows? What kind of trouble are we talking about?
Once you have the parts, you will meet me there, at the gate beyond the village of Mother's Heart.
The North Gate? At the edge of the Embrace?
Yes. Now be on your way.
Is something else bothering you? Anything else? I'll get the parts. I kind of want to know if something else is bothering him, but I feel like Roast is not the kind of guy to talk. He's like, do what I say, and then I'll tell you eventually, so I'm just going to tell him I'm going to get the parts.
I'll go gather the parts, but I'm also going to pay Karst a visit.
Aloy, that man breaks the law every time he speaks to you.
And I'm glad he does. I want to buy a tripcaster, and no other trader will sell to outcasts.
Stock it with ammunition, then. You'll find use for that weapon tonight.
That sounds ominous. All right, see you at the North Gate.
Alright, cool. Well, before we go and do all of these things for the point of the spear, I'm going to go back in manual save again, and we're going to actually wrap up here, I think, for today. Yeah, I'm just about at an hour. We're almost at that point. So by the time I get back there, we'll look at the menu and stuff for a minute, and then I'll wrap up. See if there's anything I'm missing. Also, grab these items. Whoops. Press X instead of triangle. Gotta get used to the commands. The commands, controls, same difference. It's going to be fairly difficult switching between three games, especially two fighting games between Berseria and, well, not, you know, not fighting games, but actual combat games. Digimon World Next Order doesn't have as much need for precision combat, but this game looks like it will, and then Tales of Berseria does to an extent where it comes to, like, chaining combos and whatnot. But anyways, ooh. All right. I like this map. Oh, wow. This map is a lot bigger than I thought it was. Holy cow. Alright, what do we got in the inventory that's new? Anything important? Resources. We've got Sparker, Wire, Ridgewood, and Fire Kiln Root. Okay. I'm liking the look of this game so far. I've heard a lot of good things about it, and I was really looking forward to it when I saw trailers and whatnot for it. I think it was, I first saw it at 2016's E3? That sounds right. A bunch of undiscovered stuff here. Errands, side quests, main quests, active. All right. Cool. Well, I really like this setup, man. It's looking really good. I like this skill tree. It's basic. Simple to understand. You can look ahead for future skills and whatnot. I love it when skill trees are fairly simplistic, not too complicated. Two different words. I don't like them being too complicated. The more simplistic, the better. But anyways, that is going to be all for today. Let me save up before we call it. So thank you all for watching. I hope you're excited for this new playthrough. I'm definitely really excited for it. It looks like it's going to be a ton of fun, and I am pumped to play through this game. I'm expecting great things from it. Hopefully it does not disappoint me. But yeah, I'll see you all next time, and until then, farewell.